Want to stream your PS5 gameplay to a chat or call on Discord? Well, here's how to do it. Step 1 is to go onto your PS5 and add a new PSN user. You will only need to do this if you want to eliminate lag entirely when streaming the gameplay, but if you are willing to put up with input lag, then you can skip this step. Once you've set up this second PSN account, go to Settings, then Users and Accounts, then Other, and make sure that console sharing and offline play is enabled. Next, tap the PS button, go over to your profile, and switch users to one you want to be playing on when you're showing your gameplay to the Discord call. With that now done, head on over to your computer and open up your browser. The browser I'm using is a sponsor of this video, Opera GX. Opera GX is the first ever browser dedicated to gamers, and it's completely free, so I'm really excited to be working with them. It's packed with tons of amazing features, such as this sidebar which lets you check messaging apps such as Discord, Twitter, WhatsApp and more really easily whilst browsing. That same bar also has a player function, which you can link to Spotify, YouTube Music or Apple Music etc, so you can control what you're listening to without swapping tabs or apps. Speaking of integration, Opera GX also has a free VPN that's built straight into it. Now that's awesome. Furthermore, the GX control tab lets you control the system resources being used up by the browser, so you can improve the performance of your games, speed up video editing, or whatever it is you might be doing. It allows you to place strict limits on Opera's CPU and RAM usage, so it's never going to take up all your memory like Chrome might. Your browsing experience and whole computer is going to feel so much faster with Opera GX. On top of all of that, it's available on both Android and iOS mobile devices too. It's never been easier to change browser either. With just a single click in the settings, everything from your current browser is transferred right over. So if you want to get Opera GX for free, then check out the link in the description and improve your browsing experience instantly. Anyway, when you're in your browser, you'll want to download PS Remote Play. I'll leave all the relevant official download links for Remote Play in the description. Whilst you are looking for the links, you should totally drop a like too if this guide works for you. Once PS Remote Play is installed, open it. You will now be prompted to sign into your account. Now, in order to avoid lag on the stream, you'll want to sign into that second PSN account we just made, not your main account. If you want an explanation as to why the second account is necessary, check out the pinned comments. And whilst you do that, leave your own comment letting me know what game it is you're trying to stream to the Discord call. I'd love to know. Once you're signed into that second account, simply select the PS5 option to connect to your console. If you are signed in on more than one PS5, then you'll be given a list to choose from, so just select the console you are trying to stream your gameplay from. If your PS5 doesn't show up, make sure that Remote Play is enabled within your PS5 system settings. With that done, the connection process should now begin. After a few seconds, your PS5 screen should be shown and you are connected to your console now. The quality and frame rate of the PS5 stream you see here is adaptive, so it just alters to provide the most stable video your connection can handle. Usually, that's going to be 1080p 60fps, and that honestly looks brilliant. Now that you have your PS5 gameplay visible, head to your Discord call or voice channel and select the option to share your screen. Now here, you're going to want to select to share just the Remote Play window, so that sound is also shared. If you choose to select your whole screen to share, then sound is not going to pass through. You can then choose a resolution and frame rate to show your gameplay at, so unless your connection is quite poor, just select the highest options available to you. Oh, by the way, this is my own Discord server I'm currently streaming to, which you can join using the link in the description. It's a nice small PlayStation community, and I sometimes do giveaways in there too. I'd love to have you as a part of it. Anyway, everyone in the call can now view the stream to see everything on your PS5, just like if you were using a capture card. Pick up your controller, and you can play whatever you like using your PS5's usual display and on your main account, meaning that there is no input lag. You do not need to play by looking at the Remote Play window, that's why using the two account method is just so good. However, some of you might notice a message shown permanently saying that Remote Play is connected. Luckily, you can remove that from the screen by going to Settings, then System, then Language, and changing your language to something else to then change it right back to your own language instantly. Hopefully, there's an easy toggle added for this message in the future though. If you want to know how to link your PSN account to your Discord profile to show game activity, then watch a video on screen now. Also, like this video to say thanks if I was able to help you out, as well as subscribe for more unique PlayStation tips. Anyway, that's all from me in this video, and I'll see you in the next one.